Caffeine is a psychoactive drug, just like alcohol and cocaine. This means it can change or alter brain function. Of course, it's found in small amounts in coffee and energy drinks, but would you drink Coca-Cola if it contains small amounts of cocaine? Coca-Cola was made with coca leaf extract from 1885 until 1903, which is basically cocaine. Would you drink Coca-Cola if it contained cocaine today? I wouldn't. And I don't drink Coca-Cola anyway because it's just not healthy for the body. It just contains too much sugar. Would it be a sin if I drank a cup of Coca-Cola today? Most probably not. But if I kept drinking it and I become addicted to the sugars from it, and I continue to eat and drink irresponsibly until I become overweight and my health deteriorates, then that might be a sin. Is drinking coffee a sin? Most Christians who say drinking coffee is not a sin are those who are addicted to it and are not willing to put it away. But I'm not making a law out of this. But the same one can say, is smoking a sin? I want to give you a real life example. My uncle is addicted to coffee and he literally cannot stay without drinking coffee for more than a few hours. If he does not drink coffee, he becomes irritated. He's not himself anymore. He cannot function properly. I was lucky because when I was 10 or 11 years old, I drank a coffee and I had a stomachache, so I disliked it since. So I don't drink coffee, but it's not the same for many young people. Once they start drinking coffee, they will always drink coffee. If you are a young person and you see other people drinking coffee and it's popular and all that, you don't have to do it. You can choose not to drink coffee and you will definitely not become addicted to it. Try to avoid drinking coffee, especially if you are a young person. You have to understand that some people are less tolerant to certain things and coffee produces addiction, and you don't want to be addicted to something, to anything that can harm you. Plus, one addiction can trigger other cravings which can convert into other addictions. For example, some people who drink coffee like to smoke in the same time and so on. That's when it becomes very difficult to give up those addictions. Anyway, this is my recommendation. The best thing to do is to pray and ask Jesus and let him show you and teach you. And be receptive to what he's showing you. May Jesus bless you.